Now we come into the presence of another red light. We have come here to the third danger signal that he puts up here. And this danger signal is like a red light. He's getting ready now to drive out on the highway again. And before he does, he says, we got to look both ways. And this is very important. Here in the remainder of this chapter, there is the danger signal, the peril of being dull of hearing. And here is a passage of Scripture that we need to pay attention to because it's a very important passage of Scripture. Here from verse 11 on down through the remainder of this chapter, the peril of being dull of hearing. And then in chapter 6, he's going to mention another danger signal before he gets to this subject of Christ, our high priest after the order of Melchizedek. And that's the peril of departing. Now, we are coming, as many of you know, to that great chapter, the 6th chapter of Hebrews. And we want to finish this section so that next time I can give all my attention to this marvelous 6th chapter. And we recognize the problem that is there, but we're going to deal with it. Now, will you notice here, he puts up the red light now, verse 11, of whom we have many things to say. Paul says, I've got a lot of things to say, and hard to be uttered. Now, why is it hard to be uttered? The problem was seeing ye are dull of hearing. Paul could state it, but they couldn't grasp it. Had you ever stopped to think sometime that when you go to the church, and if you have a Bible-teaching pastor, and you say after church, maybe to your wife or to your husband, you say, I don't think the pastor today was quite up to it. I didn't feel like his message was quite equal to what he is capable of giving. Had you ever stopped to think that the problem may have been that day with you, seeing ye are dull of hearing? The problem may not be in the speaking. The problem may be in the hearing. It's ear trouble today that is the big problem of believers, of hearing the Word of God. Now, the problem is just simply this, and he's going to deal with it quite forthrightly. Christ is a priest after the order of Melchizedek, but it's a difficult subject that requires sharp spiritual perception. It requires folk to be spiritually alert, those that have a knowledge of the Word of God and are close to the Word of God. His readers, the Hebrew believers then, he said they had a low SQ, not an IQ, but a low SQ. That is a spiritual quotient. Spiritually, they were way down. It's hard to be uttered means that it was difficult to make them understand, hard of interpretation to speak, and the reason for it was because they were little babies. All they understood was baby talk, da-da-da and goo-goo-goo. And that's all that some of the saints want today. They like baby talk, even from the preacher. They don't want something that is difficult. And I say this carefully. That's the reason that some preachers are getting by with murder today in the pulpit. They murder the Word of God. They absolutely kill it, and they give something else or give nothing in the world but their own viewpoint. My friend, may I say to you that the reason is that a lot of folk like